who I was, I am yours. Not my mistakes, not who I was, I am yours. Not my mistakes, not who I was, I am yours. Not my mistakes, not
Oh, church, I've been contemplating whether to share this word, because when I came in this evening, I came for an encounter. Every moment I stand before the presence of God, I normally tell God I've come for an encounter, a fresh encounter. And as the worship team was leading us, the word of God reminded me, and it says, where the word of God is, it brings balance in all things that we are doing. And God told me that prayer is one way, one weapon of defeating the enemy. Fasting is another way, because Christ said, this cannot be defeated unless by prayer and fasting. But then he went forward and reminded me of 2 Chronicles 20, when King Jehoshaphat was faced by the enemy. If you read 2 Chronicles 20, it says, when he was surrounded by the Moabites and all the other three nations that were against him, and even when this gentleman was singing that song, that though there are many, but they are surrounding us, but it is you, O God, who is surrounding us. Your multitude, your presence is around us. 2 Chronicles 20 was bubbling in my spirit when he was singing that song. And I said, what a moment. Because it says that when King Jehoshaphat went to God, God said, just praise. So praise is a weapon. And I told God, I'm standing here, and whatever challenges that I'm facing, as I worship and praise you, you have gone, like you defeated. Guess what? If you read 2 Chronicles 20, read all of it. It says, God caused the enemies to arise against the three kings that were coming against the Israel, and they killed them all. And when God testified this, he said, when Jehoshaphat and the rest came up again to check where the enemy battles were, they found, the Bible states, that every one of them was dead. None of them who arose against the children of Israel survived. So none of the challenges that you and I are facing today, as we have praised God today, none of them will stand. Whether it is your, because I don't know where, what level you are in, I know the battles I'm facing, but none of them are standing. As we have continued to worship, none of them will stand. If it is healing, deliverance is coming. If it is bondage, even it says, even the captives, they'll be set free. They are being set free. Every shackles of darkness, where there was no light and you're looking for an understanding, God's light has come forth. Where there was weakness, God has brought strength. Where the head was going down like this and you're walking head down, God says he's a lifter of our heads. He has lifted it up. Where you thought at work that they have risen against you, guess what? God has sent angels against them. God has gone forth to bring you breakthrough. He has brought me breakthrough. That one I'm sure. As I leave this place, I know my battles have been won. Why? Because I'm a son of God. You are a son of God. So whatever challenges you are facing, please, my brother and my sister, just know as we are worshiping, worship is a battle. David was singing and Saul's spirit was doing what when it was down? The Bible says what? His spirit was, that demon that was pressing Saul, it had to be lifted up when David was singing. What about your praise and my praise? And he calls us the high priest in Philippians 4. We are the high priests. So as we have been in the presence of God, it was a weapon. That is a worship is a weapon. So let's use it mightily. Amen.
Amen. So that let's continue to worship. That is an amazing worship.